be faithful, soon Jesus will come. For whom
the chief shepherd and the thief shepherd. I'd like to believe there are so many people whom we call reverend, prophet, bishop, pastor, who are not worthy of that name or title. Nobody should take up any position in God's church before he beholds the model of shepherding from the Son of God. There are some shepherds and shepherdesses who have now the tone of the dragon.
Deep, such unbounded and infinite love, who died to redeem us his own.
I'd like to greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We want to thank the Lord for gathering us here today again, that we may delve into his word. As our habit, we also want to greet our friends who are watching the telecast in different countries across Africa, parts of Europe, and parts of Asia. God bless you out there. Feel free to go through this study of the Bible with us here in Johannesburg at Georginia SDA Church. God loves Georginia. Amen.
Amen.
He's launching an important program to be heard by many from Georginia. If any church is going to be judged with a high standard by God on the judgment day, it's Georginia. Because they've had the privilege of hearing great things. Are you with me? If any church is going to be revived more than any other church, it should be Georginia. Amen. Our topic for tonight is very exciting. It is simply called the chief shepherd and the thief shepherd. The chief shepherd and the thief shepherd. Yesterday we looked at the crisis of shepherding from the Old Testament and in these last days. And what is happening these days in the circles of shepherding or leadership styles at different levels in the Christian world and in the church constitutes one of the signs of the last days. We discover that many are no longer taking instructions from Jesus Christ. They are now a law to themselves. They do as they please. Amen? And they forget that it is the flock of the Lord. And they forget that, many of them forget that they are trustees entrusted to look over the sheep of the Lord. They do not have ownership. So tonight we are looking at the chief shepherd and the thief shepherd. Maybe before I draw your attention to the book of John chapter 10, let me begin with Exodus 25 verse 8. I think you know it by head. Exodus 25 verse 8. This is the scene where God called Moses up the mountain and he said, let them make me a what? A sanctuary that I may dwell among them. Verse 9 says, according to all that I show you. After the pattern of the tabernacle and the pattern of all instruments thereof, even so shall you make it. God gave Moses a pattern or a model. Are you with me? Moses was not just going to build the sanctuary together with the church, the Israelites, but they were to build according to a pattern revealed by God. I remember when Noah was asked to build an ark, God again specified exactly how the ark should look like. Are you with me? God has never left any man in his church to do as he pleases. He has always given a pattern. Amen. And so, we defined yesterday and said a shepherd does not only refer to a pastor, it also refers to all the ministers of God, whether they be prophets, elders, deacons, or departmental leaders who have oversight over some people or the sheep of God. A youth leader is shepherding the youth. Amen. Women's ministries leader is a shepherdess over a flock of women. Am I right? So there are various departments, and there is the shepherd, the pastor above all the departments, and the chief shepherd, Christ himself. Some are captains over thousands, others over hundreds. Remember when God asked Moses to delegate duties, remember? He said, make some captains over hundreds, some over 50, some over thousands. And he says, let them judge. Let them guide the flock, and the hardest matters they must refer to Moses. You remember that? So don't say the shepherds are the pastors only. You are also in charge of a department. There are people under you. Amen. And now it's very important to take to pay attention to this lesson. Even in shepherding, God has not asked any church leader to do as he pleases in the church. If he gave Moses a model, he gives us a model also of leadership or shepherding. That's what we are going to dwell on tonight. There is a great outcry in many circles because of the way certain individuals are leading out. They are scattering the sheep. Amen. Some will not come to church until a particular elder or pastor is dead. Then they will come. I don't think it is right. Amen. If God says, let them make me a sanctuary according to the pattern I show you, maybe this verse should also have been included, which I wrote here. let them shepherd my flock after the pattern that I show you in the Good Shepherd. Maybe there was supposed to be a text like this. What do you think? Let them build the church, the sanctuary, after the pattern. Another verse would have said, let them shepherd my church or my flock after the pattern which I show thee in the Good Shepherd, that I may dwell among them. John chapter 10. John chapter 10. Let's try verse 11. John chapter 10, verse 11. Let's have it up on the screen. It says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. Here is a model of shepherding presented by Christ, the chief shepherd. I am the good shepherd. And the good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. So the model of shepherding or leadership presented by Christ here is that of a sacrificing shepherd, one who sacrifices even his life for the good of the flock. Are you with me? Nobody should take up any position in the church before he beholds the model of shepherding. You are not understanding what I'm saying. Are you there, my friends? Nobody should take up any leadership position in the church without beholding the pattern of shepherding as displayed by Christ. As Moses never went down to construct the sanctuary without beholding the pattern first. Those who have come from Christ are those type of leaders, type of fathers, types of husbands who lead their families, who lead the church, who lead various departments with a spirit of self-sacrifice. Are you with me? Even their own lives to benefit the flock. So Christ gives us this model. To sacrifice, the meaning of the word sacrifice according to the dictionary is the act of giving up something that one values. Are you with me? For the sake of something that he considers more valuable. Are you with me? something that is valuable to me, I give it up for something that I think is even more valuable. In other words, Jesus values his sheep more than his own life. Are we together? He sees value in each believer. He sees value in each child of God. Amen? He saw value in man whom he made in his own image, that he despised his own life to redeem the human beings. Are you with me? So when you are shepherding the Jesus way, when you are leading the Jesus way, you place value on God's people. You don't place value on yourself. If you look today in the Christian world, how many leaders are placing value on God's people, or on the church, or on the congregation? How many are prepared even to give up their lives that the people of God may be saved? If a man takes up any leadership position, whether it be a pastor, an elder, a deacon, bishop, priest, you name it, without beholding the shepherding model of Jesus Christ, he becomes a curse to the church. He becomes proud and arrogant and stubborn and bullish, and he bullies the sheep. Remember the presentation yesterday? Christ complaining to the shepherding styles in the Old Testament. He raised Ezekiel to rebuke those type of shepherding styles. Christ sees value in each sheep. That he says, I'm the good shepherd, I leave 99 sheep to go and look for one and that is gone astray, to spend sleepless nights until he recovers the lost. Do you believe in this Jesus? Are you a follower of this Christ? If yes, the Bible says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ, the chief shepherd. I'd like to believe there are so many people whom we call reverend, prophet, bishop, pastor, who are not worthy of that name or title. Strictly speaking, if we compare them to this standard that Christ has set for us. Are you with me? I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. He gave up his high position in heaven for sheep. He gave up being adored by holy angels for sheep. For 31 years, there was a vacant throne in heaven. He was missing from his father's right hand. And the angel said, where is he? Said, he's gone for his sheep. And he left his glory above, and he took flesh and blood for sheep. Many people claim to be his followers, but they are not clothed with his mind. If we want revival, behold the chief shepherd. Amen. And be a partaker of his mindset and attitude. Are you with me? Do you see value in the next person seated to you? Do you see value in those in the beer garden? Christ saw them valuable and he came down. Who am I to despise a human being who was made in the image of God? Christ, the good shepherd, offered his life to be sacrificed on the cross. Amen. He did not sacrifice the sheep. How many are sacrificing the sheep? He did not sacrifice the sheep. He sacrificed him. If a man leads without beholding Christ, he will sacrifice the church to save himself. He will milk the sheep to benefit himself because he has not been in the school of Christ. Are you with me? Let me tell the people out there in Mozambique and Namibia that the people of Georgia are too quiet, you know. They don't say amen when you're speaking to them the words of Jesus. Okay. John chapter 10, verse 3. The good shepherd and the thief shepherd. John 10, verse 3. Are we there? To him, the good shepherd, the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his sheep, his own sheep, by what? By name, and he leadeth them out. Behold, the chief shepherd. Nobody should take up any position in God's church before he beholds the model of shepherding from the Son of God. The porter is like the caretaker of the sheepfold. Are you with me? When he sees the good shepherd coming, he opens the door. He knows this is the owner of the sheep. Amen. So he opens the what? The door. And he says, now, his sheep hear his voice, and he calleth them by name. This suggests something. Jesus is the model of all shepherds. His model of shepherding is that he knows each sheep by name. He has time for each sheep. He has time to visit each sheep and to know each sheep and its needs and to minister to the needs of each sheep. Are you with me? That's the type of the model of shepherding from the chief shepherd. I know some people who occupy high positions in the church, whether head elder, head deaconess, whatever, title, pastor, evangelist, who will complete their term of office without knowing each member they lead, without even visiting their homes, without even knowing their individual needs, nor praying or ministering to those needs. On the judgment day, the Lord will say, son, daughter, tell me your shepherding style. From whom did you behold it? Are you with me? How nice it is to have those religious name tags upon ourselves. Awesome names like Reverend, Head Elder. What a scary name. Are you with me? Very nice names, but the model of shepherding is not Jesus-like. You'll hear what Jesus says here. You'll hear what he says. I know them by name. Aim to know every member in the church by name. Aim to know those individuals in the department which you lead by name. Aim to visit them in their homes, know their children and the challenges they face, and pray for them. Nowadays, we have what we call pulpit leadership. You didn't hear what I said? We have what we call pulpit leadership. And Jesus says, my sheep will not follow a stranger. I'll talk about that. If you're a pulpit man only, you become a stranger to the sheep. I know them by name. And he says now, the porter openeth and he calleth his own by name, and he leadeth them out of the sheep fold. He goes ahead and the sheep follow. I have a video clip of how people tend sheep in Israel. The shepherd goes ahead and the sheep, whether 100 or 200, they follow behind. When he stops at some plain where there's green grass, then they start grazing there. When he starts moving, they follow. So Jesus says, I don't drive people to follow me. I don't whip them or force them or threaten them to come after me. They voluntarily follow after me. Jesus is not a dictatorial shepherd. Whence comest dictatorship in the religious circles? Whence comest dictatorial eldership in the church of God? In the church boards? To me, it means many people who sit there who do these types of things have never been in the school of Jesus. They've never enrolled at the feet of Christ to learn the model of a heavenly shepherding. There is no room for compulsion, no room for force. Amen. It is following by choice. And he goes ahead of them, and they step where he has stepped. In other words, going ahead of the sheep denotes exemplification. Jesus exemplifies everything before the sheep, and they follow his what? Example. I want to say, a man or woman who is going to the kingdom of heaven is a good example of Christianity. Exemplify Sabbath keeping before the flock. You're not listening to what I'm saying. Show us an example of how the Sabbath is kept. And new believers who follow your example. Show us an example of good Christian speech. And the people who follow. Am I right? So the call to shepherding, the call to leadership, is a call to exemplification of the Christian virtues. Amen? Shepherding and leadership is not a command and control thing. It is demonstration. Are you with me? How many are commanding and controlling in the house of God? Dictating and prescribing. The flock wants to see an example so that they may follow. Give us an example, man of God, of a Christian family life. And young couples will follow. The youth will follow. Demonstrate. One day Jesus went to the River Jordan and demonstrated how, true baptism. Am I right? He was immersed into the water and he came out. And so today, we immerse in the water, out. Are you with me? As his custom was, Luke 4:16, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He exemplified Sabbath keeping. He has never asked us to do anything anyhow. So when you are in God's house, please, you were called to exemplify self-sacrifice. Don't talk about evangelism, demonstrate evangelism, and the people will fall. Show us how to give Bible studies, and the people will fall. Today we have many bad examples in the Christian world, in the churches. Am I right? What remains only are religious name tags, but the examples are not worth following. The good shepherd does not demand respect. He earns respect. For the sheep follow him out of their own will. Are you with me? Let me move on. John chapter 10, verse 4, the good shepherd. I'm coming to the thief shepherd part. Good shepherd, thief shepherd. Verse 4 says, and when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his what? Sheep know his voice. That's why they follow him. The voice of the master. The Savior's model of shepherding is again demonstrated here. The voice of Jesus, the voice of the chief shepherd, is a voice of love. Amen? The sheep know his what? Voice. It is a voice of what? Love. There is a loving tone in that voice. Even sinners love to hear that voice. It is not a condemning voice. Are you with me? Whoever takes up any leadership position in any church, watch your voice, brother. What tone comes out of that voice? Fault finding. Accusative tone. Am I right? And the sheep don't hear that. Sinners don't hear that. They want to hear the voice of the shepherd, a voice of compassion, the voice of forgiveness. Hallelujah. And they know his voice. That's the master. Compassionate, forgiving voice, loving voice. I don't know what voices are coming out of today's leaders in different positions. Is it the voice of love? Voice of fault finding? Judgmental tone? The sheep will draw away from such type of leaders. Are you with me? Watch your voice culture, sister. I know of the accuser of the brethren. He's called the devil. There are some shepherds and shepherdesses who have now the tone of the dragon. Accusers of the brethren. How many were baptized by being accused? Can I see your hands? I really received Christ and I was baptized because I was accused. Do you know of any who gave their lives to Christ because they were accused? I know of those who accepted Christ because they were forgiven. They know his voice. Tonight, friend, Jesus does not accuse you. He speaks to you tenderly. Come unto me. Though your sins are as red as scarlet, that's the voice of the Master. May that voice be heard in the church boards. The church board should not be eager to censure people. Didn't hear what I said? The church board should not be studying how to censure people. It should be eager to exhibit the tone of the Christ. If men take up positions without knowing Jesus, they become spiritual terrorists to terrorize the sheep. To compel the sheep. Am I right? Verse 5, John 10, verse 5 says about the good shepherd. John 10, verse 5. And a stranger, they will not what? I didn't know that John 10 was so powerful. John 10, it's too powerful. A stranger, my sheep will not follow, but they will flee from him. For they don't know his voice. Who are the strangers? It is any man in a religious office or position who got there not by, through the school of Christ. He came into that position without beholding the what? The model and the pattern. And his leadership style is strange. It's not Jesus-like. When the good shepherd knows each sheep by name, he does not know each sheep by name. And so, if you don't visit me in my house to pray for me when you are my leader, you are a stranger to me. I only know you when you make announcements. I only know you when you're asking for money in the offering plate. You are a stranger. In my house, you don't know me. You don't know how the sheep live. You don't know what their challenges are like. And so we are praying for revival. Amen. That we may shepherd in the Jesus way. A stranger, they will not follow. Strange deacon, they don't follow. Strange women's ministry leader, the sheep will not follow. Strange youth leader, the youth will not follow. Strange pastor, the people will not follow. Are you a stranger tonight? To the people in your department, to the people in your church, maybe to the people in your district, stranger. Pulpit leadership will not work at this time. What will see us in the kingdom of heaven is to behold the pattern, like Moses, and build according to the pattern. John 10 is a great passage. They will not follow, it means they will boycott him. When he calls for a prayer bed meeting, people will boycott. When he calls, guys, let's go evangelizing, he's a stranger. They will boycott. Whatever program he calls, remember, he imposes programs. So he doesn't want input. He has no ears like the little horn, remember from yesterday. So they will boycott. And they will not support. And I've heard some people who blame the congregation. They say the congregation has a wrong attitude. No. The thief shepherd does not blame himself. He blames, they have an attitude towards me. Always defending himself. Jesus says, if you are a strange deacon, strange elder, strange pastor, his sheep will not follow you. If they know not your voice, because the tone of Christ, when they listen to the speech, the voice, there's no compassion in the voice. No forgiveness in the voice. There is commandeering in the voice, and they say, that's not the tone of our master. So they know his voice. So what people are looking for, friends, they just want to hear Jesus speaking through you. They just want to see Jesus' attitude through you. And he will draw many to himself. Why are churches half empty these days? Perhaps they are not seeing the voice of Jesus through you. If that voice is heard, many will be drawn in. That's according to Jesus. The thief shepherd, John 10, verse 1. Evaluate your leadership style. Maybe in your family first. In your family first. Amen? Is the elder sister, elder brother, and those behind you, do they know you? Do you know them? Do you know their individual needs? Do you tell them, my brother, I am praying for you. My sister, I'm praying for you. Then they know we have an elder sister, elder brother, and they will respect you. Are you with me? John 10, verse 1, what does it say? It says now, verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say to you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, he that entereth not into the sheepfold by the door, but climbeth up some other way. The same is a what? A thief and a robber. The thief shepherd and the robber shepherd. Can you see him there? He that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. And Jesus says, I am the what? The door. I am the door. So he that does not enter into the sheepfold, into the church, into any position in my church, not through the door, not through me, but climbs up some other way to land into head eldership, to land into head deaconship, to land into the pastoral position, not by me, but some other way. The same is a thief and a robber. True Christian leaders have proceeded from Christ. They have learned at the feet of Christ how to value sheep and how to lead sheep, and they have the heart of the chief shepherd towards the sheep. But today, many have climbed some other way. I talked about the other way last time, the way of church politics, the way of being smuggled in by friends to certain positions. Yes, they have the position, but Jesus says, if they never came by me, watch their attitude towards the sheep. They are thieves and robbers. Number one, they rob Jesus of his glory. They want the glory themselves. Are you with me? Some of them these days are almost worshipped as Jesus. Little gods. When I know, when I've come from Christ, and I know I am a trustee, do I take the place of Jesus? Are you a thief tonight? If you climbed some other way, if you've come by Christ, by the door, you do it the Jesus way. Amen. I don't think it is good to say, Lord, remember me in your kingdom as I pray and fast. I think the best thing to pray for is help me to reflect Christ in my leadership style, in my relationship with God's people. Amen? In this earth. If I reflect that, automatically I'll be saved. Are we together? Verse 10, John 10, 10. What does it say? Talking about the thief shepherd. Verse 10, the thief cometh not but to what? To steal. And to kill. and to destroy the sheep. The good shepherd came to save the sheep. The thief shepherd came to destroy and to kill. I am come that they might have life, that they might have it more abundantly. Friend, true Christian people, Christian leaders, Christian husbands, they have this mind of Jesus in them. They have come to give life, the life of Jesus. Amen. But those who have not come by Christ, they kill churches, demoralize people, demoralize departments. Are you with me? And what remains only? Religious name tags. The Lord is dishonored. Can you see this? It is a great sin that will cost somebody his place in the kingdom of heaven. If people knew the responsibility of leadership in the church, they would not politic for positions. Amen? There is a fearful responsibility attached to being a leader in the church, whether of a department or as a pastor or whatever level, because you'll be measured against the great pattern called Christ. I know those who have killed the spirituality of certain people or certain families, that people have backslidden. Are you with me? I know people who doubt and say, is that a man of God? Referring to an ordained man. Are you with me? Why should people doubt? It's a sign that we are not beholding Christ. Because if we behold, we reflect it. Amen. The thief shepherd comes to destroy the spirituality and to kill the spirituality of people and to scatter the sheep. Somebody says there are some people who view church leadership as a job, not a calling. Did you hear what I said? It's a job, not a calling. If it's a calling, your heart is into it. Your life is into it. Amen. You actually sacrifice even your time for the benefit of the sheep. Today we have people who are too busy that they don't even have time to serve the master, time to minister to the needs of the sheep. Are you with me? Do you think these guys will be happy when Jesus comes with the rewards to give to each man according to what he has done? Or you will say, depart from me, for I never knew you. But Lord, I was a pastor, I never knew you. I was the head, no, I didn't even know you. Because you never registered at the school of my feet that you may learn shepherding. Are we together? Now, when the thief shepherd is in, the sheep are scattered, there's backsliding, and he doesn't care whether others are missing from the fold or not. Are you with me? The good shepherd goes to seek one that is missing. The thief shepherd climbs some other way, and he scatters. He doesn't care who is in or who is out. He doesn't see God in the church. He sees gold in the church. Are you with me? That's why he milks the sheep. Let me show you the perspective of Jesus, the chief shepherd, towards the sheep. And compare yourself as I with Christ, as I compare myself with Christ. Matthew chapter 9, verse 36. The good shepherd and the thief shepherd. Verse 36 says, Matthew 9, 36. But when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with what? Compassion on them, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Then saith he unto his disciples, the harvest is truly plenteous, but the laborers are few. When the chief shepherd, Jesus Christ, looked at the congregations in his day, when the Pharisees were acting like the shepherds of the flock, are you with me? He saw harassed congregations who were fainting, abused by the Pharisees. Are you with me? And it says he was moved with what?
Compassion.
One of the chief characteristics of the chief shepherd is compassion. A heart that sympathizes with the people. Amen. A heart that sympathizes with the sinners. A heart that reaches out to save those who are lost. It's one of the prerequisites of shepherding. Whether you're a Dorcas leader, youth leader, whatever position you hold, do you have a heart that sympathizes and reaches out to those who are lost, to those who are harassed by wrong doctrines? Do you care or you don't care? I know some people who know all the doctrines of the church, but they don't have hearts that they reach out. Theirs is a dry doctrinal religion with no heart, with no feeling for the lost. Let me pray for the heart of compassion. Let me pray for the heart that reaches out. Let me pray for a heart that is concerned about the salvation of other people. If you have this type of attitude, then Jesus is dwelling in you. Are you with me? You may be called a pastor, a priest, bishop, elder, evangelist. If you have no heart, according to Jesus, you are not a shepherd. You are a strange shepherd, and the sheep will not hear you or follow you. Jesus says in John 10:16. In fact, before I go to John 10:16, in Matthew 9:36, there Jesus is saying, look, I'm seeing sheep that are being made to faint. The Pharisees' leadership style caused the sheep to faint, to be weary. Instead of being inspired, the people were wearied. Are you with me? With the rituals and other burdens, and Jesus was not happy about that. Are you the type of a person who is a wearisome husband? Wearisome mother, wearisome elder, wearisome church board. Jesus is concerned. And he says, now, he was moved with compassion and he saw them as sheep having no shepherd. But there were shepherds there. But he says, no, there are no shepherds according to the divine standard. Are you with me? People may say, we have a head deacon here, we have a Dorcas leader here, we have a pastor here, or whoever. But Jesus may say, there's no shepherd there. if he doesn't see his heart in those that tend the flock. And he says, now, look, the harvest is great. When he looked at these scattered, fainting sheep, he saw them as a harvest to be gathered into his fold. Amen. But he says, but there are few laborers. The church was full, but he says, yes, it's full, but there are no laborers. Today, churches are full. People enjoy going to church, but Jesus says, there are no laborers who will go and labor and bring in the sheep into my fold. Are you the kind of a man who enjoys coming to church, but you don't love to labor for Jesus? So that's why he says, yes, churches are full, but there are no laborers. He's looking for laboring women, laboring men, who are willing to go and labor to bring them in. Amen. John 10:16. Hear the heart of the good shepherd and contrast it with the thief shepherd. John 10:16 says, and other sheep I have which are not in this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. So Jesus came down from heaven. His will is that every human being be saved. Amen. I have others who are already baptized, who are in my fold, who keep God's commandments, but I still have others out there who are still drinking, who are still womanizing, who are still worshiping images. I want them in as well. Amen. So who will help me to bring them in? Those who have learnt at the school of Christ and beheld the model of divine shepherding have the same heart as Jesus. They yearn to reach out and bring them in, while the thief shepherd will scatter them. and even discourage some from coming to church. Amen? In these last days, the Bible says, you shall know between him who serves God and him who is a pretender. Amen? Not all who say, Lord, Lord, shall be saved. God brings this message to you tonight to surrender your life to Jesus, to enroll in the school of Christ. Amen? To behold the great pattern of leadership and shepherding from the chief shepherd, and that from this time onwards, you may walk in his way, and he will use you, and he's willing to forgive. Remember, just take stock of your life. Are there people who have stopped coming to church because of you? Their sin will be charged upon who? You. Watch your influence. Amen. Are there people who have stopped to come to church or to follow Christ because of you? For every lost sheep, a man will give an account to Christ. Amen. Let us know that he bought each one of us with his own blood, and that he values us to the point that he gave his own life. Let me finish by reading the mission of Jesus Christ. Sometimes people attend church and pray for revival and talk about Jesus while they don't know Jesus and his mission. May I remind you tonight of Luke chapter 19, verse 10. Luke 19, verse 10. I am the good shepherd. I left my Father in heaven. I left my throne in heaven. I left my glory, and I came, took flesh and blood. What was your mission, Jesus? For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost, to recover it, to bring it in. Amen. That's the mission of Christ, the chief shepherd. All true shepherds who have come from the Master have this mission in their heart. Amen. They view each sheep as valuable. Today we hear of shepherds who rape some church members, sexually abuse. Have you heard that in the Christian world? Yes. Who are swindling church members? Are you with me? Contrasted their mission with the mission of Christ. It says in the last days, there shall be false Christs and false prophets. Am I right? Who shall come in my? You will be taken for a ride unless you know the mission of the true shepherd. Are you with me? Tonight, my brothers and sisters, let's give each other a challenge. Let's pray for revival. As Jesus is looking for co-laborers to go and seek and save the what? The lost. Why don't you say, Lord, here am I. Use me. I am willing to go and bring them in by pen, by voice, by my whatever I have, here am I. Count me among the remnant workers. If any man has sinned in any way concerning his leadership style, there's still room to be forgiven. There's still room to say, Lord, I am sorry. Give me a new page. Tonight we are going to conclude as well by singing our theme song for the last time, because our meeting is coming to an end. And we shall conclude again with a season of prayer. Can we have the song on the screen? That song is words that touch me especially. I hope they touch you too. The Master is saying to you, go and seek my sheep and bring them in. Amen. Okay, let's sing it with a passion. I'm going to ask you to stand up. Please stand up. Those at home, open your hymn books or sing with us this great song. May it be your theme song. God bless you.
Bring them in, bring them in, bring.
much. Tonight we are going to have a special prayer. I want to pray for those with special needs. There are those who are saying, Lord, forgive me. I have not been looking at your example. I have not been loving people. I've had grudges with people. Lord, give me a new heart. We'll pray for a renewal and revival. Amen. We also want to say, if any person has a special request, personal requests, social, marital, financial, health, I don't know what it is. But if you come to Jesus willing to serve him, he will take care of your life. Sometimes we want him to bless us materially when we don't want to be his servants. It doesn't work that way. You give your life to Christ, he becomes Lord of your life, and he then manages your life. Amen. Somebody saying, Lord, manage my life. Take over everything. Here am I, Lord. Do I have somebody like that? If there is somebody like that, I would like you just to come up front here and kneel here. But if there is no need for such movement, remain standing where you are. I want to give this chance to anybody who says, Lord, I need a special prayer. I will not give an interview of what's happening in your life. No, it's not my right to do that. Okay? It's between you and God. I will simply pray to the Lord together with my elder. Don't follow your friend. Let conviction of the Spirit take place in your heart and humbly kneel before the Lord. This prayer meeting must be concluded on a high note, and the Lord will sort issues out in your life. Amen. Jesus loves each sheep. By name, he knows the needs, and he is able to reach out to you personally and touch you where you need to be touched. And he's able to forgive you. He's able to cleanse you. He's able to qualify you to be a shepherd after his own pattern. Amen. Come closer, friends. I see there's space, there's movement. Fill up this space here. Anybody says, I need a special prayer, unless God intervenes in my life, I am undone. Please come up here. Okay? I'll ask these ones to kneel down here, reverently. Those at the back, humbly bow as you stand. We also pray for you. Amen. Good. And also you pray for us in your private prayers. Our Father who art in heaven, we want to say thank you in Jesus' name for gathering us here, Lord, for this revival series. Thank you, Lord, for lifting up your Son before all of us. Thank you, Lord, for raising him high that we may behold him. Thank you for promising us that if we look at him, we shall be changed and we shall be transformed forever. Lord Jesus, I want to thank you tonight, for you did not die in vain. You died to save people. Here are your children, Lord. Nobody forced them out of their seats, but willingly they followed the chief shepherd. They've seen him, Lord, and they come to him, and they are saying, Lord, help us. I know you love sheep. You care for sheep. You left 99 to go and look for one. Here are your sheep, Lord. Meet them at their point of need. Bless those with healing who have need of healing. Bless those financially, those who have need of finances. Bless those, Lord, with marital blessings, those who have need of such blessings. Forgive those, Lord, who have need of forgiveness. Father, refresh those who are weary, and give peace to those who have a guilty conscience. Those, Lord, who have been enslaved by the devil in particular sins, may you free them for Jesus' sake. And above all, Lord, I pray for the whole congregation. Bless Georginia Church. Bless them again in 2015. I want to pray, Lord, that you may bless even our cameraman, Mr. Ntalambi. Do him a good, Lord, for he is doing a great work. Wherever this broadcast and telecast shall be viewed and screened, may the Holy Spirit accompany these messages to different homes. May our names be written in the book of life. Dismiss us now, Lord, with a blessing. And those who receive answers from you in different times, give them power to stand up here one day and say, I want to thank God for he delivered me in that revival series. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.